Hello, and good afternoon to all my respected teachers, faculty members, our honorable principal and guests, and all my seniors, juniors, and fellow batchmates. I am Deepshikha Das from NSHM Knowledge Campus, Durgapur, thrilled to welcome you all present here in this auspicious celebration of the World Tourism Day 2020. This is a difficult time for everyone with COVID-19 limiting the way we gather. When we lose the ability to come together physically to celebrate, to grieve, or to acknowledge the milestones and rites of passage we each face, it can be devastating. Yet, our social distancing and gathering restriction do not mean that we can no longer honor our moments of change with intention and meaning. There are ways to come together and when we can't meet physically. With that, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to say light and brightness has always been equated with positivity and motivation as seen as the harbinger of good. By lighting a lamp, the lamp becomes a form of fire or tej, as we call in Sanskrit. The light burns not to be the light itself, but merely as a message to remind all who are present of peace or of hopeful and positive brightness. So, to start us off on an auspicious note, we will now have the light lamp ceremony. Thank you so much. Wow, this really filled our heart with warmth and enthusiasm. Now, moving on, we are going to talk as usual about the brief history of the day and know why the travel professional organization and enthusiasts from around the world celebrates this day like a festival.
A special assembly was held in Mexico City on 27th of September 1970 by the International Union of Official Travel Organization and adopted the statutes of World Tourism Organization. Then, UNWTO decided in late September 1979 to institute World Tourism Day. It was first celebrated on 27th of September 1980. Do you know why 27th of September is chosen for World Tourism Day? It is because this date coincided with an important milestone in world tourism, that is, the anniversary of the adoption of UNWTO statutes on 27th of September 1970. Also, according to the UNWTO, the date is appropriate for World Tourism Day because it comes at the end of the high tourist season in the Northern Hemisphere and the start of the tourist season in the Southern Hemisphere. With different theme every year, this day is celebrated with full enthusiasm. Since 1980, the United Nations World Tourism Organization has celebrated World Tourism Day as an international observances. The purpose of this day is to raise awareness on the role of tourism within the international community and to demonstrate how it affects social, cultural, political, and economic values worldwide. In the year 1997, the UNWTO General Assembly decided to designate a host country each year to act as the organization's partner in the celebration of World Tourism Day. UNWTO has designated 2020 as the year of tourism and rural development. This year is an opportunity to promote the potential of tourism to create jobs and opportunities. It can also advance inclusion and highlight the unique role tourism can play in preserving and promoting natural and cultural heritage and curbing urban migration. For the first time in the history of World Tourism Day, The 2020 official celebration will be hosted by a group of countries and not a single UNWTO member country. The cross-border cooperation of Mercosur nation or South Atlantic nations, Argentina, Brazil, Paraguay, Uruguay, and Chile reflects the current need for international solidarity and cooperation. This is especially true for tourism, working together towards a common goal. In 2019, our country India hosted World Tourism Day, and the theme was Tourism and Jobs, a Better Future for All. In 2018, the theme was Tourism and Digital Transformation. And in 2017, the theme was Sustainable Tourism.
That was some huge and truly moving information we got. Now, moving forward with the celebration, we are going to hear some words from His Excellency Mr. Zura Pololikashvili. He is a Georgian politician and diplomat, currently serving the post of Secretary General of the World Tourism Organization. He was a former Georgian Deputy Foreign Finance Minister, and he served as ambassador to the Spain, Morocco, Algeria, and Andorra.
For many rural communities, tourism is a true lifeline. It provides employment and opportunities outside of big cities, most notably for women and youth. Tourism also promotes inclusion and helps rural communities hold onto their natural and cultural heritage. But the real power of tourism has yet to be fully realized. This World Tourism Day will recognize the unique ability of our sector to drive rural development. This ability is needed now more than ever, not just as we recover from the pandemic that has affected us all, but all we began the decade of action. We now have less than 10 years left to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals and make good on promise to leave nobody behind as we build a better future for people and planet. This year we also celebrate 40 years of World Tourism Day and 75 years of the United Nations. There has never been a better time to recognize tourist potential to transform and support rural communities all around the world. Today we pledge to transform this potential into reality. Wherever you are celebrating, happy World Tourism Day.
Such mesmerizing words. Now, we all know this year's theme, right, which is tourism and development. But what does that really mean? To know that, we must watch the next audiovisual.
visual. 2020 marks the 40th anniversary of the World Tourism Day. UNWTO has designated 2020 as the year of tourism and rural development. This year is an opportunity to promote the potential of tourism to create jobs and opportunities. It can also advance inclusion and highlight the unique role tourism can play in preserving and promoting natural and cultural heritage and curbing urban migration. World Tourism Day, commemorated each year on 27th September, is a global observance day fostering awareness of tourism's social, cultural, political, and economic values and the contribution the sector can make in reaching the sustainable development growth. A renewed focus on the benefits of tourism to rural communities is timely and important because rural areas face increasing challenges of aging populations, declines in traditional economic activities, and depopulation. Tourism has been one of the fastest growing and most resilient socio-economic sectors of our time. In many places, the benefits of tourism, including enhanced employment opportunities and economic growth, are concentrated in urban areas, particularly cities. New technologies, innovation and entrepreneurship, a growing interest among travelers demanding experiences connected to the places they are visiting, as well as easier connectivity, open new windows of opportunity for tourism in rural areas. Harnessing the power of tourism to drive rural development will enhance the sector's contribution to achieving the sustainable development goals, particularly goals of no poverty, gender equality, decent work and economic growth, sustainable cities and communities, responsible consumption and production, and partnerships for the goals. The COVID-19 crisis is an opportunity to build back better for the tourism sector, investing in models that place a focus on the empowerment and engagement of local communities, inclusion and the preservation of local natural and cultural resources. This crisis further stresses the importance of building resilience among communities where tourism is an important share of their income through product and market diversification, fighting seasonality, social protection, and building value-added experiences. Thus, tourism and rural development is more relevant than ever as the global tourism sector faces up to the COVID-19 pandemic. Tourism in rural areas offers important opportunities for recovery, making supporting rural communities facing the economic and social impacts of the pandemic is critical.
Such a wonderful video we saw just now. Felt like just travel some beautiful rural destination and meet some native people. I think this really helped to bring the heat. Now, I request my fellow anchor, Ms. Paramjit Kaur, to take the lead from here.
Thank you, Sai. Good evening, everyone. I am Paramjit Kaur. Now, I would like to invite Dr. Milan, principal of NSHM School of Tourism and Hotel Management, to say a few words.
Very good evening, and to all the people, all the students, all my faculty members across Durgapur and Kolkata, all my lovely students and our guests today. Very, very good evening and namaste from NSHM, School of Tourism and Hotel Management, and wishing you all a very happy World Tourism Day. And the theme is also really very nice and amazing. Okay. There are some tourism experts today, so you all will hear from directly from them. And before that, I would like to share a small story, which is very important at this moment. There is a book called "The Obstacle Is the Way," which is written by Ryan Holiday, and there is a chapter called "It Is Up to You." And in that chapter, there is a small story which talks about basically Tommy John. Tommy John, I don't know how many of you remember about and know about him. He was a great baseball player, and he was a great pitcher also into that. And he started his rookie year, basically he started when John F. Kennedy was a president, and when he last played George W. Bush, so almost 20 years he played. And once what happened, he blew up his arm and there was a ligament issue. And that was totally dead. And when he went and met with a sports medicine doctor and the surgeon, they said, nothing can be happened. So his career was almost dead. And he asked one question, is there any opportunity? Is there any chance? So doctor said, okay, we can go for experimental surgery. And if it works, so then he asked that, what is the chance out of 100? He said, 1%, there is a chance that you can, but for sure that you will not able to play, but yes, you can work with your hand. He said there is a 0 and there's a 1. So there's the biggest chance between 0 and 1. He said, we'll go for experimental surgery. And he went for that. And with all kind of physio and rehabilitation, you won't believe he only played. He played almost for another 14 years. And after that, he won 164 titles. So why I'm narrating this story here right now? And after that, this surgery is famous in the world called Tom John surgery. So what I'm telling you that is basically the chance, and what we talk about 0 in 1, 100 chance that you can change it. So lot of people, lot of things are happening across India. People are talking about and world COVID and all that. It's just a temporary phase. And if you are excited to do the change, it is up to you. It is up to us. So, you know, there is a famous phrase called what is up to us and what is not up to us. So what is up to us is basically our emotion, our judgment, our creativity, our attitude, perspective, desire, you know, decision, determination. These are basically up to us. And what we are doing today, no one has ever thought that we will celebrate World Tourism Day virtually, but we are celebrating. People are excited, students are excited. They are participating in all the activities, and all my faculty members are excited to give you a new thing. So the three word I would say all of you to remember, you know, and I as a faculty, as a teacher, at the end of the day, I'm also a teacher, I'm practicing. First is accept. Second is adapt. And third is change. So when you talk about acceptance, when the moment you start accepting anything, you will go for a new change. And once acceptance is there, then you become adaptable. And then after adaptation, the change comes. So if you remember from 16th of March, we went for online from 18th March. And this semester, we are completely online, all LMS, classes, everything online. So we have accepted, yes, this is the truth right now. We cannot change the world, but we have adapted also. And those who are adaptable, only those survive. You know, Charles Darwin say, no matter how big you are, no matter how intelligent you are, no matter how strong you are, the only animal who survive, only pedigree who survive, who know how to change. Like dinosaur, you know, they were very strong. They're very strong, and suddenly they disappeared from the earth. You know why? Because they were not adaptable to change. Their food habits made them extinct from the animal planet. So this is what I'm telling all of you, that you should be ready to accept, adapt, and change. And there's a model called CURT model, you know, which talks about, you know, unfreeze, implement, and refreeze. So everyone's talking about new normal and new pedagogy and everything. Yes, we are into this system. And only those who will survive who are very agile. When you talk about agility, it basically talks about, you know, there is a word we call VUCA word, you know, vulnerable, uncertain, you know, changing, and agile. So those who are very, very agile, you know, they can only, you know, and very complex, you know, when you talk about the environment is very, very complex. But what is up to us is basically how we are, balancing our emotion, how we are keeping our attitude very positive all the time. Okay. Time is same. It's not nothing changed. Sometime COVID has come. Sometime you find some challenges. Sometime you find other challenges. But this is the obstacle. And you know, the most important thing, you know, obstacle? You have to embrace the obstacle. Till the time you don't embrace the obstacle, you will not be able to move further. And only those people will survive who will accept and who will start changing very fast. So I'm very happy. And very, very happy from bottom of my heart that my students are doing so pretty well. Since last 3.5 months, so many activities we have there, either it's a webinar, online seminar, virtual alumni meet, virtual graduation meet, lot of classes, assignment, everything. People are doing extraordinarily well with the support of all my beloved faculty members. And wishing you again all the very best for the program, and wishing you again a very, very happy World Tourism Day. Enjoy. And before I close, what I would say, go back to your roots. I was talking to one of very important person you must be knowing, Dr. Siddhikan Misra, who's the chairman of all IITM. I was talking to him and I said, sir, we have to go back to roots, and everything is our heritage. You know, how the harvesting done, how the people do the farming, the paddy farming and everything, the local puja, local ritual of all villages, these are all our heritage. And we, as a student of tourism, it is very, very important. And you have to take this responsibility that you are helping, just not celebrating World Tourism Day on virtual. If you are able to help any people who are in rural area, and if you are able to tell them that how you can promote your things, either it's a handicraft, either it is a local festival, either it's a local harvesting festival, there are so many things. And believe me, this is the heritage of the village. And Indian people are very, very rich. Still, we live in a modern town. We live in a big cities. We live in a metro city. But still, our roots are there in the village. So my humble request to all my coming students and upcoming students, that this is your responsibility. It is our responsibility to keep our roots very high, to respect our roots very high. No matter, my father is my father, my mother is my mother, my student. I cannot think for others, and I should feel proud of our Indian heritage. It's amazing. This country has given so many things. You talk about mountains, you talk about, sea, you talk about river. And the oldest civilization of world is our Ganges civilization. And we should feel proud of it. We should not only think about what, a Western historian have written about India due to colonization. This is something that what we read, it's a very unfortunate. But I would say all the students from tourism, read your geography, read history again from class 8 to 12 NCERT book. You will find that what we are basically and how we are going ahead. So I will not take much of your time. Thank you so much and wish you a World Happy Day once again. Thank you so much. Over to you, Paramji.
Thank you so much, sir, for your... Yes, sir. Thank you so much for your precious words. We have with us Mr. Avik Ghosh, Deputy General Manager in Club 7 Holidays. He has also worked in regional and national level of many farm tour operators like SOTC, Yatra.com, Orchid Holidays, and many more companies. He has experience of total 19 years. I would like call him to enlighten us with his thoughts.
Hello. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Mr. Ghosh, you are very much audible. We can hear you.
Thank you so much.
Namaste.
And yeah, I said namaste. And so, it was so relevant that you have spoken 50% of my words. Thank you so much. It was so relevant. And I had planned something, and trust me, you have taken 50% of my speech. So I can understand your position, and it was so nice to meet you virtually here. And all my beloved new freshers, all the freshers and all the students and all my respected teachers and the principal, trust me, we all know that we are going through a little bit rough phase, but as you all know that we have careers spanning over 30.
Industry. It's around
35 years which are remaining. So for me, maybe I have come a little bit midway, but it's just a slog over. Everybody has a bad over in cricket. Everybody has a rough phase. It's just a coincidence. It's just a rough phase, but very much temporary. Very, very, very much temporary. It's just let me this like... sections. Some of them definitely are now trying to go out, maybe in small segments, maybe not international right now, as you all rightly know that there are challenges regarding travel and visa and all the other facilities like international travel, and some domestic travels are also prohibited. But some of, like in all countries, not only Goa, not only Kerala, not only Northeast, but in all the countries, people are now traveling, people are now frustrated. They are now starting to travel in domestic areas. Trust me, rural, we are speaking about rural development. Maybe this is just a coincidence this year, but this cannot be more relevant, more than this year. Because definitely rural development will face economic... Hello? Rural development will face economic growth and employment, But trust me, more than economic development right now, tourism itself needs rural development. Tourism itself needs rural tourism. Trust me, because we are all, as of now, we are stuck in our houses. We are ordering food and having inside. We are doing webinars inside our home. We are doing work inside our home. But the only thing that we are all hungry about that cannot be in the home, that is tourism. People are like everywhere, in all the cities, in all the countries across the world, people are very much hungry. So once we open, once the tourism opens, maybe a few months from now, it's just a bad pace. So we will be opening with a boom, I think. And locally, we need more of the like rural tourism because of the culture, as sir has already pointed out, because of the culture, because of the rich heritage, and because of some practices which we really, which we want now in a Desi style, in farming. Sometimes from childhood, you must not have done farming, but people are now hungry about, they are mentally hungry about learning all these things. People are resorting to cycling, to adventure tourism, to cycling tourism, as I told you, to walking tourism, as I told you, to village tourism, to rural tourism. They are now spending pujas, as sir has also said, that trust me, now the many districts of East India also, I'm sure, for all over India and all over the world, many districts are having all these Rajbaris, all these mansions. They are all transforming them to hotels, to resorts, and people are going and celebrating there, maybe an Eid, maybe a puja, maybe everything, maybe near, they are now resorting to those new segments of tourism where they are spending 3-4 days, they are farming locally, they are plucking flowers locally, they are enjoying with the natural heritage, natural local tourism guides, that is local cultural activities, the dancers, the performers. They are getting to know their roots, and they are spending well. And regarding, and just another 2-3 minutes, I would like to venture out to a very relevant thing that is all into your heads as of now, we can understand, to especially to our students that who are going to step into this tourism industry. Maybe now they are a little bit perturbed. Trust me, I am into this industry for 19 years and maybe will be in the industry for a few more years. But we have to be ready, as sir has already indicated. We have to adapt this change. We have to accept this change. We have to adapt and we have to implement. Trust me, now it's survival of the fittest. Trust me, many people, many crores of people have lost their jobs across the world. Definitely, tourism is one of the most affected, because unless you are fit, you will not travel at least. The travel is into the last list of priorities, but mentally, it is one of the most important priorities. So buck up, be positive, be happy. And another thing, when you step into the world after like doing these courses from NSHM, which I'm sure that like you have really gained from, but you need practical knowledge, because you will be going as freshers, but there are already crores of people who have lost jobs and they are wanting to regain their jobs. But your advantage is the people who have already lost jobs, they are into a middle level of career and they will want a little bit good amount of money from their salaries to be back. But as you are freshers, you will not need that much of money to step into the sector. So it's your advantage. People will take you, but then again, as you are fresher, they may find a little bit like skeptical to do it. But I think balancing your freshness with some knowledge, with some handholding, is very important. Practical handholding, practical knowledge is very important to step in, so that, for example, when you go into an interview, you can say, sir, I am confident, or you are actually confident, or you are actually knowledgeable, like a guy who is 2 years experience. Maybe you are not like a 5 years, 6 years experience guy. I cannot make you ready for that. But at least 2 years ready, 3 years ready, yes. You know the sources, where to look from, where to search from, and where to, and now it's enough time. You have that time to search and make yourself ready. And trust me, we are all here. I have attended many programs. The Kolkata guys know me. Maybe the Durgapur guys are seeing me for the first time. I will be helping you students. Like if you need anything about practical handholding, after this session, you can take my numbers and my, whatever my contacts. But if you need ever a practical handholding or whatever, trust me, we have to be positive and we have to adapt this change. And best of luck within few months, within 2-3 months, 5 months maybe, God knows. And with all positivity, fingers crossed, we will see you in the market. And best of luck, all you guys. Thank you so much. Over to you, Paramji.
Thank you so much, sir, for sharing your knowledgeable thoughts. Next, we have with us Mr. Uttam Shankar Mishra, one of our NSHM alumni, who is the founder of Trikeen Travels Private Limited, New Delhi. He is taking care of inbound and MICE business. A decade of professional career has asked to enroll him through all major verticals of travel and tourism business.
Good evening, everyone. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Hello. Okay, great, fine.
Yes, sir.
So, great. So, good evening, everyone. My principal, Dr. Milind. I really thank Prasanjit sir for inviting me on this happy moment, World Tourism Day. The theme is rural and development. Tourism and rural development. Sorry. And I also want to extend my greetings to the students. And basically the future travel entrepreneurs or the travel businessmen. Now, you see a different background, right, everyone? Now, see, this is what tourism and rural development is. Luckily or coincidentally, I am here in my village and we are celebrating World Tourism Day, where the theme is tourism and rural development. Dr. Milind and Mr. Ghosh also spoke about farming, our heritage, everything that is rooted to the villages and our culture. Here you can see everything, and this is what I'm enjoying here right now in this COVID session. Now, where everyone just spoke, and actually the situation is also that the entire world is is very tense. We all have a new normals. If you see in my background, I don't know if you guys can see it or not. The boys are playing they're enjoying a lot. They're playing cricket. So this is the life in village. Very untouched. They don't know what the world has, what the news channels have. They are informed. They are well informed. But life here is something really very different. You cannot tune into whatever the practical world outside is giving into. They enjoy a lot, whatever the situation is. I will talk about 2-3 points because we are all into this new normal. Okay. Now, while I'm interacting with the students here, everyone has in the mind that we are into a very, very, very bad situation. And yes, it is. It will be very wrong of me if I don't admit it, that I am, as an entrepreneur, as a businessman, I'm not in a troubled situation, but I'm enjoying this, frankly speaking. Because we are all into this world of change, where all the dynamics of business, of traveling, of rules, of communication has changed. Now the golden rule for you, the students who are into this academic sessions, is that, like, for example, I have avoided myself for joining all the webinars, all the web chats and whatever it is during this entire session. This is my first time, so excuse me for any mistakes or whatever it is. But new students, as I like, kind of, you are engaging yourself from, I think, March end or whatever the time from where the situation came in. You are engaging yourself in all these webinars, in all this digital communications. You are the learners of this. Now, when you come into the world of a new world, that is after your 2 years, 3 years, or even 1 year of the for the final year students from now, you will be having a much upper hand than all the entire industry people who are, as Mr. Ghosh said, that are there in mid of their careers or somewhere like in kind of at the edge of their careers. You will always have the benefit. So be positive about this. This is my golden rule, the golden word for you, my the students basically. Now the second thing I will say, that the industry trends, like, you know, because we are into the industry, we are into the business, right? So I'll tell you the industry trends is that, yes, the travel industry, and we have suffered a lot. I mean, immense. Okay, you cannot imagine the number of job losses or whatever it is. It is true, and it is. But if you remember, I am a student of your, like, in kind of, I am an alumni of NSHM. I used to be behind the dais of NSHM celebrating World Tourism Day, you know, being a host. Now, here I'm just like a speaker to you in front of you. I would say that I was into the session of 2006-2009, okay? I passed out in 2009. If you guys remember, the world was facing the great recession time during 2007 to 2009. I passed out in 2009. Although the world was, means the world was was very much affected by the Great Recession, India was not that much affected, but it was not untouched also. The tourism industry suffered then. Now, when I passed out my course in 2009, and when I landed up in the industry, believe me, the entire 10-year stretch from 2009 till March this year, I was diving into the land of opportunities. I worked with brands, big brands. I worked with Make My Trip, Kappa Travels, or whatever, in all the different roles. Everything was there. Then I started my own company, and I'm here right now. So the point of saying this is, after the Great Recession, then the world was again into a new normal, which were back then. These new normals are new. So whatever the world has faced earlier, we gained from it. Nothing is here to stay. Now, COVID will stay. That's the fact. That's the true fact. We have to adapt ourselves to these new changes. You are the masters of it. You are the learners of this period. You are into an educational institute where you are learning how to communicate digitally, how to be, means, prepared in terms of all the aspects which are new normals. Frankly speaking, this is not a time where we can say that this is a 3 months time, this is a 6 months time. Believe me, this is the new normal. You have to accept it, and this is how it will run. Who imagined that I will give a speech from my village? I never thought of, like, coming to my village and giving a speech, an audio visual like this, where my fellow students are in kind of they are hosting on just behind the dais, on just on a screen, and whatever it is. So just accept it. This is the new normal. You are the masters of it. And when you come out of this your academic sessions, you will rule it. Thank you, everyone. Once again, I will convey my thoughts about tourism and rural development. Is this is what rural development, the buffalo you can see, you know, the workers you can see, this is the rural development. Many people, migrant workers, even including me, like I am from the state of Bihar. Okay, I'm from the state of Bihar, and I went to Delhi for a job. Now, since everything is like halted there, everything is stopped, I'm afraid that like if I go out, I'll pass out something. I'm a COVID survivor till now. I'm proud to say, and touch wood. But yes, this is what rural development is. People from all the big cities, they have come here wanting to settle. As Mr. Ghosh said, that the people who have their bungalows or their heritage houses, they're converting them into hotels or something like, you know, kind of providing a good tourism stay, like, you know, stay for the tourists. Hotel facilities they're developing into. So this is what it is. Now, I would like to conclude my speech regarding this, that be motivated. Yes, I am afraid right now, and you should be also, but you have to adapt the changes and you will rule it. Thank you so much, everyone. Have a nice evening. Over to you, Paramjit.
Thank you so much, sir, for sharing your experience. Now, I would like to call Soumya Singh, my fellow anchor, to lead the further event. Soumya, over to you.
Good evening to all and all present here. It's a pretty all the excitement and delight. It is I, Soumya Singh, here to take you up forward with the culture program. So let's gear up for a mesmerizing beginning of the show with the purest form of art, that is dance. So our first performer is Madhurima Jash. She is going to present Bharatanatyam. What a beautiful performance, Madhurima. Moving on to our next performance by Ankita Paul. She is going to recite a poem named Tej, written by Devrat Singh.
मु जामबनी कुइडी पाड़ा शिव कुइडीर बिठी साज लिब ठी कागज लड़ा बोलले अतटुकु बोलले खब एकने तुम इबार कार माध्यमिके प्रथम होइचो तोमाके बोलते हबे आरो किछु टीवी वालारा बोलले तुम खेत मजूरेर मे तुम केमन करे कामिन खेते माध्यमिके प्रथम होले बोल देखि सेटो तोमाके बोलते हबे खुले पंचायत रानी बौदी प्रधान उपप्रधान एमएलए एमपी सब एक बार हमलाइए पड़ल हमारे मटर कूड़े घरे जामबन स्कूल हेडमास्टर को बिहन बेलाय तीनगर खुलले हेके डेके घूम भांगाय खबर तो जख प्रथम शुनाले तक मा के जड़ाए शुए मामू कूड़े घर घुटघुटे आधारे हेडमास्टर मशाई देखे चोख कचाले मायर पड़ा हाँ हुए भाइले छिलेन एक स्वप्न देखी ना कि सर बोल एटा सफल लय सत्यि बटे कथाटा शुने कईदे भाषा छिलुम आमरा दो मा बेटी आज बाप बेचे थकले मानुषा के देखाइते पारतम बहुत किचू আমার বুকের ভিতর যে তেজালো সিঞ্ঝা বাতিটা জ্বালাইছিল মানুষটা সেই বাতিটা আজকে কেমন আমাদের কুমিরে ঘর থেকে আলো কইরেছে সেটাও দেখাইতে পারতাম আপনারা বলছেন বটে তোমাদের মতো মেয়েরা যদি উঠে আসে তবে ভারতবর্ষ উঠে আসে কথাটা খুবই সত্যি কিন্তু উঠে আসার রাস্তাটা যে এখনো তৈরি হয় নাই খাড়া পাহাড়ে উঠা যে কি জিনিস বহুত দম লাগে বহুত ট্যাজ লাগে আমি জামবনের কুমিরি পাড়ায় শিব কুমিরের বিটির সাজ দিই যখন থেকে হুঁশ হয়েছে তখন থেকে শুয়ে না আসছি বিটি না মাটি ঠাকুমা বলত পরের ঘরে হিসেব খেলবে তার আবার লেখা পড়া গায়ের বাবুরা বলত তুই কুমিরি পাড়ার বিটি ছিলা তোর কামিন ঘাটা ছাড়া গতি কি বাপ বলত দেখ সাজলি মন খারাপ করিলি তো হেরে গেলি শুন যে যা বলছো বলুক সেসব কথা এক কান্ধে সিন্ধালে আর কানে বার করে দিবি তখন বাবুপাড়া দেঘয়েরা ঘরে কামিন খাটত মা ক্ষয় রোগের তারও সে মায়ের কতটা ভাঙে লাই অতটা মাঝে মধ্যে জ্বর তো রায়তো বটে জ্বর এলে মা চুপচাপ আঙ্গেনাতে তালাই পেতে শুয়ে থাকত মনে আছে সে ছিল এক জাঁড় কালের সকাল রোদ উঠেছিল ঝলমালানি ঝিঙ্গা খোলা রোদ আমি সে রোদে পিঠ দিয়া গা দুলাই পড়ছিলাম ইতিহাস কেলার সেভেনে সামন্ত রাজাদের ইতিহাস বেঘরে গেলি লোক পাঠাইছিল বারপাতক মায়ের জ্বর সে তারা শুনতে এলাই যায় আমাদের দিদি বুড়ি তখনও বাইচে ছেঁড়া কম্বল মুড়ি দিয়ে বিড়ি ফুঁকছিল বুড়ি শেষতক বুড়ি সেদিন পড়া থেকে উঠায় মায়ের কাজটুকুন করতে পাঠাইছিল বাবু ঘরে পুরনো ফটক ঘেরা উঠান অত বড় দরদালান অত বড় বারান্দা সব ঝাড় পাড় দিয়া সাফ সুত্র করে আসছিলাম চইলে দেঘরে গিয়ে নাই চাইলে এক গাদা ইঠা কাঠা ঝুঠা বাসন আমার সামনে আইনে ধইরা দিলে বললুম আমি তোমাকে ঝুঠা বাসন দিতে লাইব বাবু গিন্নি সে কি রাত কি বললি যত বড় মূল হয় তত বড় কথা জানিস তর মায়ের মা তার মায়ের মা সবাই এতকাল আমাদের জুটা বাসন ধরে গুজারে গেল আর তুই আমাদের ঝুটা বাসন ধুতে লাড়বি বললুম হ আমি তোমাদের ঝুটা বাসন ধুতে লাড়ব তোমরা লোক দেখিলাও গা আমি চললাম কথাটা বইলে গট গট কইরে বাবু গিন্নির মুখের সামনে আমি বেড়াই চলে এলাম
তা বাদ সেই নিয়ে কাণ্ড কি ঝামেলা বেলা ডুবলে মা তো ধান কেটে বাপ ঘরে ফিরে আইলে দুপাতা লেখাপড়া করা লাতে নিয়ে ছোট মুখে বড় থুতির কথা সাত কাহন করে বলেছিল বুড়ি দিদি মা কোনো রাগ আর নাই আগর মাসের সন্ধ্যাবেলায় আঙ্গিনাতে আগুন যাইলে গা হাত পা শিখছিল মা একমাথা ছাঁকড়া চুল ঝাঁকানো বাপের পেটানো পাথরের মুখটা ঝলকে উঠেছিল আগুনের আঁচে আমি বাপের অমন চেহারা কোনোদিন দেখিলাই বাপ সেদিন মা আর দিদি বুড়ির সম্মুখে আমাকে গাই ছেড়াইকে মাথায় হাত বুলাই কম কমা গলায় বইলেছিল যা করেছিস বেশ করেছিস। শুন, তোর মা, তোর মায়ের মা, তার মায়ের মা সবাই করেছে কামিনগিরি। বাবু ঘরে গতর খাটাই খাইছে, তাতে হয়েছেটা কি, তাতে হয়েছেটা কি, এই কথাটা মনে রাখবি সাঁচিলি। তুই কিন্তু কামিন হবার লাগে জন্মাসলাই, যত বড় লাশাহেবি হোক না কেন, কারো কাছে মাথা নোয়ায় নিজের তেজ বিকালিলাই। এই তেজটুকু লেগে লিখা পড়া শেখাচ্ছি তোকে, না হলে আমাদের মতো হাফ হাতা মানুষের ঘরে আর আছেটা কি। আমি জামবনের কৈরি পাড়া শিব পুজির ব্রিটিশ সাঁচিলি, তবে কার সেই কেলা সেভিনের কথা ভাবতে যায়, কাগজওয়ালা আর টিভিওয়ালাদের সামনে এখন যে কি বলি। তাল পাতার রদ দিয়ে ঘেরা গোবুলতা নাগেনাতে লুকে এখন লোকাকার, তার মাঝে বাঁশি বাজায় জিপ গাড়িতে চাইপে, আগু কিছু পুলিশ নিয়ে মন্ত্রী আইল এক ছুটে। কোথায় সাজলি তুই রে কোথায়, বলতে বলতে বন্দুকধারী পুলিশ নিয়ে সুজা আমাদের মাটি খুঁড়ে ঘরে। হেডমাস্টার বলল, প্রণাম কর সাজলি, প্রণাম কর। মন্ত্রী তখন পিঠ চাপাইলে, পিঠ চাপলাই বললে, তুমি কামিন খেটে মাধ্যমিকে প্রথম হয়েছ, তাই তোমার দেখতে এলাম, সত্যি বড় গরিব অবস্থা বটে। তোমাদের মতো মেয়েরা যাতে উঠে আসে তার লেগেই তো আমাদের পার্টি, তার লেগেই তো আমাদের সরকার। এই লাও 10,000 টাকা চেকটা এখনই লাও, শুনো আমরা তোমাকে আরো ফুল দিব, সম্বর্ধনা দিব, আরো দেদার টাকা তুলে দিব। এই টিভির লোক, কাগজের লোক কারা আছেন, এদিকে আসেন। তখনই ছোট বড় কত রকমের সব ঝলকে উঠলো ক্যামেরা, ঝলকে উঠলো মন্ত্রীর মুখ, না না মন্ত্রী লয় মন্ত্রী লয়, ঝলকে উঠলো আমার বাপের মুখ, গনগনা আগুনের পাড়া আগুন মানুষের মুখ। আমি তখনই বইলে উঠলুম, না না কি টাকা আমার নাই লাগবে, আর আপনারা যে আমায় ফুল দিবেন সম্বর্ধনা দিবেন বলছেন তাও আমার নাই লাগবে। মন্ত্রী তখন ঢোক গিললে, গাছে দেঘরা গিন্নির বড় বেটা এখন পাখির বড় ল্যাটা। ভিড় ঠেলে সে আইসে বললে, কেন রে কি হয়েছে রে সাজলি, তুই তো আমাদের বাড়ি কামিন ছিলি, বল তোর কি কি লাগবে, বল তোর কি কি লাগবে খুলে বল খালি। বলল, আমার পাড়া শয়ে শয়ে আরো অনেক সাজলি আছে, আরো শিব কুমিরির বিটি আছে গা গিরামে, তারা যেদিন অন্ধকারে পড়ে থাকবে, তারা যতদিন লেখাপড়ার লেগে কাইন্দে বুঝবে, ততদিন কোনো বাবুর দয়া আমার নাই লাগবে। শুনছেন আপনারা, ততদিন কোনো বাবুর দয়া আমার নাই লাগবে।
That was such a beautiful recital. Thank you, Ankita. Save up your energy, folks. We are going to catch a glimpse of some more amazing performances. So the next performance we have Sneha Sen, who is going to perform Bihu Dance.
fail. Next, we are going to see beautiful blend of poetry and dance. So here is Samprita Bera with a fusion of lyrical.
मुट्ठी में कुछ सपने लेकर भर कर जेबों में आशाएं, दिल में है अरमान यही, कुछ कर जाएं। सूरज सा तेज नहीं मुझमें, दीपक सा जलता देखोगे। सूरज सा तेज नहीं मुझमें, दीपक सा जलता देखोगे। अपनी हद रोशन करने से तुम मुझको कब तक रोकोगे? मैं उस माटी का वृक्ष नहीं जिसको नदियों ने सींचा है। बंजर माटी में पल कर मैंने मृत्यु से जीवन खींचा है। मैं पत्थर पर लिखी इबारत हूं। शीशे से कब तक तोड़ोगे? मिटने वाला मैं नाम नहीं, तुम मुझको कब तक रोकोगे? इस जग में जितने जुल्म नहीं उतने सहने की ताकत है। दानों के भी शोर में रहकर सच कहने की आदत है। मैं सागर से भी गहरा हूं। तुम कितने कंकड़ फेंकोगे? चुन चुन कर आगे बढ़ूंगा मैं, तुम मुझको कब तक रोकोगे? झुक झुक कर सीधा खड़ा हुआ, अब फिर झुकने का शौक नहीं। अपने ही हाथों रचा स्वयं, तुमसे मिटने का खौफ नहीं। तुम हालातों की भट्टी में जब जब भी मुझको झोंकोगे, तब तब कर सोना बनूंगा मैं, तुम मुझको कब तक रोकोगे?
Last but not the least, put your hands together for Paushali Bhattacharya, who is going to present Bharatanatyam. Thank you, Paushali. that was all for our cultural. Moving ahead with the next part of the program, which is prize distribution. So hold your excitement to see the winners of the competitions held early last week. So starting with the extempo competition, the second runner-up is Alolika Roy. The first runner-up, Shobhadi Bowal. And the winner is Anish Mazumdar. For the innovative business plan, the second runner-up, Adrita Saha. First runner-up, Deepshikha Das. And the winner is, again, Anish Mazumdar. Congratulations, guys. Moving ahead for the presentation competition, the second runner-up, Subhadi Bawal. First runner-up, Ankita Mitra and Tanisha Basu. And the winner is Anish Mazumdar. Before announcing the winner of photography competition, let's have a look at their work. AV, please. The winner for your travel memory theme is Devrati Sen. Next theme is Framing the Festival, and the winner is Deepru Vishwas. And the last theme is Lens Through the Lens, Street Life, and again the winner is Deepru Das. Congratulations, Deepru. Before announcing the winners of art competition, let us introduce our judge, Mr. Mandal, Principal Rano Art Gallery, Durgapur, who has selected the best of all arts. Can we have the AV, please? Beautiful. Now, the runner-up of art competition is Shakshi Kuzur, and the winner is Anita Paul. Thank you, guys, and congratulations. Now, I'd like to call my fellow anchor, Alolika Roy, for giving the vote of thanks. Thank you.
That was indeed a beautiful evening well spent. With this, we come to an end to this program very sadly. First of all, I would like to thank Dr. Milind for his immense support to all of us. He has always encouraged us and he has played a big role in the success of this event. I would also like to thank our guests, Avik Ghosh and Uttam Sarkar Mishra, for being there today and accessorize the event. I would also like to thank our faculty members for being the backbone of this event and the students. All the performances and participants have done a great work. Everyone is deeply thanked. All the people who have worked behind the scenes are thanked for their great work. Without you, this event could not be this successful. And last but not the least, a hearty thanks to all the audience for encouraging our performers. A big thanks to everyone. And with this, I, Alolika Roy, will be signing off until we meet again. Stay safe.
Okay, before we go, the last announcement from my end. Next time, when we celebrate World Tourism Day, there should be two programs must be there. One from lady faculty member and one from the gents faculty member. There should be two programs, either poem, either dance or any activities. Because we all should celebrate, only student will celebrate. We all must celebrate this World Tourism Day. Right. So all the students, those who are listening to this, please make a record. Prasanjit sir is here, Soma madam, Soma Kumar, Arvind sir, Supriya madam, Basuti madam, all and all faculty members are there. One program. So there are four ladies are there. The highest lady department in my department is tourism. So four lady, one, and Prasanjit sir and Arvind sir, there should be one program. Prasanjit sir, are you listening to me? So if he must be there, so one program must be there. Okay. And hope we'll celebrate this function at campus next year.
Very soon.
Right? Prasanjit sir, Bhaswati madam, are you there? They must be there. Okay. So all the best. It was a great evening. Okay. Enjoy. Share your memories to all your relatives, all your friends, and tell them we are running. We have not stopped. Okay. NSHM School of Tourism and Hotel Management and NSHM Knowledge Campus is running. We are in the system. Right. Share all the pictures, everything to all the probable, you are much more faster than us. Facebook, Instagram, so many things are there, right? People should know that you are shouting, right? People should know that, yes, we are there and we are very much into the system.
Right? We are listening, sir.
I know. Next year, be ready, man, for one program.
It is a really great idea. I think it will be really a great World Tourism Day celebration.
Yes. Why not?
Sir, we want to listen to your song. Definitely. If not,
Next year, make a record. I will definitely do this.
Thank you very much for your wonderful speech. Really. It's a really wonderful, very inspiring speech. Thank you very much.
And this is our job.
Thank you to our guest. Okay. Mr. Ghosh, Mr. Uttam Sankar Mishra. We are really very proud to have you on the auspicious day.
It is required.
Thank you.
And my colleague members, my all faculty members are very, very smart, and they have a lot of inner talent that we know. So it should come with the students also. It should come in front of the student also.
I got you, sir.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, all of you.
Have a nice evening.
Bye. Thanks, my dear students. Thank you.
Thank you all.
Thank you very much.